open-ended question. What are your thoughts on VHA providers, which are, by the way, if I had to take a wild guess, 90%, if not more of them, refuse when requested to complete DBQs, which, by the way, is a VA form. So go ahead, take that away.
You know, I haven't talked about this for a while, and I'm as irritated now as I've ever been just thinking about it. It really bothers me that they don't. So one, we have, first of all, like you said, the VA is supposed to complete those. Mm-hmm. They don't, because every single VISN within the VHA, right, their leadership, they all run their ships kind of however they want, in a way that it's pretty hands off, as you could imagine. And so for whatever reason, nobody, I mean, there could be the every once in a while, as you alluded to, there could be that 5% or whatever that have done them. But that's a people thing, right? That's just some provider mm-hmm. deciding to do it because it's the damn right thing to do. But for the most part, this isn't happening. Now, it's frustrating because of a few different factors. One, we have veterans who may only have VHA as their health care. Meanwhile, they're trying to file another claim for an increase or for a secondary or whatever. And a DBQ would make life a lot easier within the VA's VBA claims benefits process, but it's not getting done. And in some cases, veterans feel it's necessary to get a DBQ. One, because they hear about how important DBQs are, and so they feel as though they need to get it. In some cases, they might not need to, but let's just, for the sake of argument, they need it. So then they have to go pay out of pocket for this DBQ mm-hmm. from some other doctor, or go to some agency organization that does this. Then we fall into this situation of, oh, the OIG's pissed off that there's these DBQs that are coming from these different places. Well, if the damn VHA would have done them, we wouldn't be in this position to go get them ourselves with our public facing ones. So it should absolutely be mandatory that the VHA complete DBQs. Quite frankly, Clay, for this is what I would propose. You want to fix the DBQ issue? No more public facing. Okay. Fine. No more public facing. All DBQs are mandated to be completed by VHA. Oh, by the way, even if you're not connected to the VHA, it's your first claim, you never even filed a claim with the VA, none of that. If you're filing a claim and your condition is on there, you can go get a DBQ from a VHA provider, period. They should just automatically have to do that. You could bring your evidence from somewhere else and get a DBQ done, whatever, and have that conversation. I think that it's a disservice to veterans that they don't do it. I think it puts veterans in a financial hardship. Sure, some people can afford to go do it. Some people have other insurance, but that's not who I'm worried about. I'm worried about the veteran who can't afford it, but is made to go do it. Because look, if you can't afford to do it, you can't afford not to do it, because the gold at the end of the road, right? So you're struggling trying to get there, and it's putting people in a bad, bad, bad position, I believe. Also, I think that when it comes to DBQs being completed at the VHA, Clay, I think that I'm going to wrap it up with this. I mm-hmm. think that the VHA, the Veterans Health Administration, needs to operate in a more customer service mindset, not from the mindset of we have a monopoly on these customers, we can do what we want. No. Wrong answer. You need to bend over backwards to serve us above and beyond and give us this beyond excellent service to where we want to come back. And I think that the DBQ piece plays two roles in that. One, it's the right thing to do, and it will help accomplish that stellar level of service. But also, it will introduce veterans to the VHA. They're worried about us going to community care. Okay, well, how about introduce us to VHA? Wrap your arms around us. Show us you care. And then when we finish up our claim, we're going to be coming back there instead of going, that place sucks. I want to go over here to community care where I feel like I'm actually getting taken care of. Back to you, Clay.
Yeah, I absolutely love that. There are so many factors. And I also love how you brought up the fraudulent DBQs, because what it seems like the VHA wants to, or the VA, excuse me, wants to eat their cake and then have it too, right? So they want both scenarios where it's like, hey, private DBQs are bad, but we won't do them, right? It's like, okay, well, what's going on? Not to mention, at the HVAC, at the hearing, the VA described the cost of DBQs. Every single DBQ completed by a contracted C&P examiner costs money. It was about $350 per DBQ on average. I'm going to guess that that was an average figure the VA threw out. With $350 doesn't seem like much until you have 2 million claims in a year. All of a sudden, that's a lot. And keep in mind, these are approved and denied claims. So the 1 million PACT-Act claims, that's just approved. That has nothing to do with all the denials. And so think of all those denials just for PACT-Act that each required a DBQ. If you have a mental health exam, a sinusitis exam, and a hypertension exam, that's three DBQs right there. Urine, I'm trying to do quick math. What is that? Almost $1,000, right? Whatever. $1,050, right? And so not only would it save the VA money, which are taxpayer dollars, by the way, but I like how you described my daughter's FaceTiming me right now. Stop that. I like how you described the fraudulent DBQ aspect to it, because DBQs are extremely expensive. And it also sucks that the best person, the number one provider to complete the DBQ, is none else than your primary care. Your doctor will beat a one-time visit to a psychiatrist. They will beat a three-time visit to some other physician in some other discipline, whatever. And if the VA is going to have that standard, which is, that's the correct thing to do, by the way. Your primary care should be the standard. If the VA is going to make it that standard, but then they say, hey, primary care, can you complete this DBQ? No, I can't. It's like, okay, well,
right.
What are we left to do? And now it forces veterans to go get an independent medical opinion. And just to be clear, the IMO and the private DBQ, there's nothing wrong with that. You will really see those shine in appeals, specifically supplemental claims and the Board of Appeals. The fraudulent DBQs really lean towards alteration of, and you can check that video out. I'm going to go ahead and leave it below in the pinned comments, because that's a whole worm of cans right there. Whole can of worms. You get what I'm saying, right?
No.
But yeah, I just can't.
Find that.
What really bothers me on the DBQs and VHA is we have the VHA.